In this video, we'll examine the key difficulties when measuring unemployment. One method of measuring unemployment is the claimant count or a similar approach. In the UK, it is called a claimant count, and in other countries, it may be called something else. In the UK, the claimant count is the number of people claiming job seekers allowance or similar benefits primarily because they are unemployed. This number may over or underestimate the true level of unemployment. Some individuals may work for cash and continue to collect unemployment, which may cause unemployment to be larger than it actually is. Others may not file to collect benefits at all, which may cause unemployment to be smaller than it actually is. The International Labour Organization is a UN agency that has created a standard household-based survey of work-related statistics. This helps standardize the statistics for more accurate comparison between nations with respect to unemployment. A sample of households is selected at random to be surveyed regarding their employment situations. Households respond to several questions about their current work situation. This helps inform the government about what is actually going on in households with respect to employment. However, as with any survey, it is prone to sampling errors. If a reflective group of the country as a whole has not been selected, this could lead to misleading results. In addition to that, sending this information to households, collecting it, and analyzing it can be a significant cost to the government. A third issue is underemployment, which is not included in the measure of unemployment. So underemployment is not measured in official unemployment figures. Underemployment occurs when someone counts as employed, but is working at a job that is below their ability or skill level. If a business executive loses their job and works as a waiter to make ends meet, they are clearly working at a position below their skill level and thus underemployed. This is obviously a problem for an economy because although this person is working in a productive capacity, they are not working at their highest capacity given their skill set. Fourth are discouraged workers. Discouraged workers do not count in unemployment because they are not in the labor force. Due to a variety of reasons, an individual may wish to work but may have become frustrated with the job search altogether. This would make them a discouraged worker and thus not in the labor force. It is vital to understand the extent of discouraged workers in an economy to more effectively achieve government growth and employment targets. These are four key difficulties that you need to be aware of when measuring unemployment. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below and let's answer them together. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.